Good.
Okay, thank you so much for an energizing first hour and a reflective first hour. And it's, again, it's so good to see you. It's so good to see all of you, and some we haven't seen for a long time. So after all that excitement, I just want you to sit back, look at this beautiful view, and take a deep breath in, and just settle into the scene. Imagine yourself sailing, paddle boarding, kayaking into this cove. It's a warm day, calm, perfect for you to slip into the water for a cool, relaxing swim. Followed, of course, by a delicious lunch and bubbly, always important. That was exactly the experience John and I had 11 years ago when we sailed from Auckland to Aotea, Great Barrier Island. This cove was our first stop after a 10-hour sail. So welcome. Thanks for being here to celebrate so many things, including you celebrating you, the great work that you're doing, celebrating TetraMap's 21st, and celebrating the birth, or Mokopuna, celebrating the birth of TetraMeme. For those, some of you we've known since before 2000, when TetraMap was still in the womb, and she was known as the four elements tetrahedron of behavior model, sort of a mouthful. Notice the TetraMap on the right reflecting the four elements, and the adorable characters on the left where Earth looks like a potato. In 2002, with a new beautifully hand-drawn tetra scene by Dave Gunson, we wrote a book entitled TetraMap: Develop People and Business the Way Nature Intended, which is based on over 5 years of corporate training. And that morphed into, in 2007, the Tetra scene was modernized and featured in the revised second edition. Magically, the scene reflected the view of our new home, Tanglewood, which was built 10 years later. And there you go with DeWitt, perceptions create reality. Fast forward to 2010, here's us celebrating our 10th birthday in Auckland, just as the Christchurch earthquake rumbled on the South Island. Alex will remember that one. He came from Mexico for that celebration. Fast forward another 11 years to 2021, when TetraMap gave birth to an experiment called TetraMeme, an experiment in non-linear planning. So why nonlinear? Because in this next normal that we're in, it's important we expand from linear step-by-step thinking and developing to an ecological approach to everything. We must be holistic and constantly aware of multiple interdependent perspectives. We pull together the best of TetraMap, which really its values and its principles of nature, and applied Bucky's design science methodology to create a planning process. This Bucky quote supported us to keep experimenting. There is no such thing as a failed experiment, only experiments with unexpected outcomes. So what is TetraMeme? An ecological framework based on metaphor of nature and the tetrahedron. Now, where have you heard that before? It's TetraMap. But here's a key distinction. TetraMap talks about and solves problems in relationships between people. TetraMeme, the focus is relationships between systems. The framework has shifted in layout and is dynamic. That is, positioning of the element triangles doesn't really matter. The behavioral adjectives that you know, firm, clear, calm, bright, are now project verbs. What the project does rather than what the project is. It still folds up into our wonderful tetrahedron. TetraMeme helps us explore the six interdependent relationships between the elements. TetraMeme, like TetraMap, uses metaphor to simplify, engage, and connect. We celebrate our teachers who remind us of the power of metaphor. We've shared Bucky's lessons from nature since 1992. After the terrible events of 9/11 in 2001, DeWitt Jones produced Celebrate What's Right with the World. We used that video with its many lessons. It was only 20 minutes long, but we shared those lessons over 2.5 days with hundreds of workshop participants in a team leadership course that we facilitated for 18 consecutive years. Key principles connect Bucky, nature, DeWitt, and TetraMap. Principles like interdependence. There are many right answers. Perceptions and beliefs create reality. It's a very important one. Hope for peaceful, loving futures. Metaphor helps us imagine strategies toward those better futures. So today, in this short session, we're going to celebrate the Pahutakawa. Let's explore four different perspectives of the Pahutakawa, which is absolutely prolific right now. We look out our window here and we can see they're just bursting into red. It's just gorgeous. Metaphors will apply to our work, our projects, all that we do. So what's really important here, as we go through the four elements, please put yourself in a current ecological project you're working on. It might be with your family as you move into Christmas and start to see fauna again. It might be an ecological project to come together. It might be with your clients. It might be in the community. And we say ecological because everything we do now must be ecological. It must. It must be holistic. It must make a difference to how we grow into the next normal. So we'll start with Pahutakawa energizes those brilliant red flowers. TetraMeme energizes people to understand the complexity of systems. Now think about your project. How does your project energize? The Pahutakawa unifies and enables an explosion of growth and diversity. Look at that tree, absolutely incredible. TetraMeme unifies us to work with nature with the understanding that we are nature. How does your project unify and enable that incredible explosion of growth and diversity? Pahutakawa solidifies. This is an incredible metaphor of the resilience of a system to hold it together and grow. We sailed into, this is on Motu'ihe Island, and we've been sailing in this bay for over 25 years. And we've watched this tree for over 25 years. And every time we go, there's a little less cliff. But it hangs in there. And we're wondering, will it be in our lifetime? That at the end of our lifetime, will it still be hanging in there? Whether it does or not, it's just such a lovely metaphor that we look at every time we go to Motu'ihe. TetraMeme solidifies project foundations based on reality. How does your project solidify for resilience when the ground falls away. Pohutukawa transform. Here are, in fact, on Tiri Tiri Matangi, two Pohutukawas. They're around 800 to 1,000 years old, and they've transformed the landscape. As this sign explains, the branches have collapsed over those hundreds of years under their own weight and formed new root systems, plus let light in for other trees and birds to flourish. TetraMeme transforms our thinking from linear to ecological. How will your project transform? So there you go, TetraMeme in a triangle. Of course, it folds up and becomes a dynamic tetrahedron where the elements are interdependent and synergistic. Let's keep celebrating. Let's celebrate what's right with your elements. We are all firm, clear, calm, bright. We also energize, unify, we got new ones, solidify and transform with our superpowers. If we're here to celebrate TetraMap, we're here to celebrate you. TetraMap is listed as one of our teachers. So it follows on that you are the teacher. Your superpower is who you are and what you do with TetraMap. Here's a quote that sits at the heart of TetraMap and one that can keep us centered through chaos. And it's a Bucky quote. He said, "You don't belong to you. You belong to the universe and you're here to serve." You're here to serve. We're all here to serve. And we do it so well, and we do it much better as a unified team of TetraMappers, a network. So let's share our superpowers, Tetra superpowers that help us serve. You'll be going into breakout rooms. What are your, and answering the question, it'll be only three of you, plenty of time in 10 minutes. What are your Tetra superpowers that serve humanity and the planet? And we'll give you a couple of examples because John's going to share his superpower.
Yeah, so my superpower is to do with unifying. So I'm able to see the interdependencies of different things, how they work together, and unify them into a framework that transforms the way we think from linear into much more ecological approach, natural approach.
My superpower is somewhere in the area of our mantra about ego to eco. Because and Dan and Suzanne will know that, you know, when we shared that concept, it was in the early days of our thinking about ego and eco. And when I think more and more about it over the years, because it's been a few years, our understanding of the fact that we are nature shines such a powerful light on our first working on going from ego to eco, and then sharing that concept with those we meet. So you have 10 minutes.
Your turn.
Take time to connect. There's some one, everyone here is just so, so important to all our futures.
The planet.
So have fun connecting and sharing your Tetra superpowers. Okay, Brett, put them in the rooms. Okay, so you all have your wonderful superpowers. And I said TetraMeme is an experiment. So let me share with you, or let us share with you very quickly, what two experiments led us to creating TetraMeme. Experiments one and two.
Oh, I have to click here, I think, first.
Okay, Luciana and Alex, who joined us yesterday at the celebration, they're in Sao Paulo, Brazil. They're both architects and educators, And they put out a call for their Nature Wisdom Project, which looks at education in near the Atlantic Amazon, working with indigenous people to bring the land back, et cetera, and looking at eco-villages and so forth. And who also joined the group was Ricardo and Mary Jessie. And they their eco-project is Arbolario Tropical, which is about agroforestry and local food forests. And you can learn about these on the TetraMeme website. We have had weekly meetings since 27th January to this year. We shared weekly experiments, mostly based on nature's principles and Bucky, because they're all Bucky people. We shared what worked, what didn't. We recorded our weekly lessons, which you can read the minutes of the meeting on the website. And we continue to be energized and unified and transforming towards regenerative futures. The journey is documented on our website. And so have a look at our favorite Pahutukawa tree. Isn't this gorgeous? This also is on Motuihe Island where we sail. See how this Pahutukawa embraces all the elements. Isn't that just gorgeous? And to celebrate the season and to experiment, you get to experiment your projects, any of your projects, with TetraMeme.org. And if you, as you go into the new year and you read through our minutes, you read through the process, if you're interested in us working with you on your project, you too could become an experiment. That would be great. So just have fun with that. Merry Christmas. I learned this greeting last week at one of the many webinars we do on sustainability with sustainability groups. And it is in Lakesh, a Mayan greeting. You are my other me. What I do unto you, I do unto myself. Here's a big what if. What if we serve, as Bucky has asked us to do? What if we serve by helping humanity to understand that nature is my other me? What I do to her, I do to myself. You can do this, and you do this through TetraMap. And with our supporting each other the way we've come together today in the last 2 days, it's just a reflection that we're on the right path. Know that though we come from all different parts of this huge planet, we're all connected. And that together, really only together, will we be able to serve humanity and the planet. So thanks for coming to the party.
Yeah.
We,
Jon and Yoshimi,
TetraMap and TetraMeme celebrate you. Many thanks.
Yeah, thank you.
And Merry Christmas.
And we hand back.
And we hand back.
Since I come home, well, my butt.